As badly as the WWE Universe wanted to see Shawn Michaels against The Undertaker, it seems that the two WWE legends wanted it even more, both giving it everything they had, both using some old tricks and some new ones. But ultimately, it ended as all of Undertaker's WrestleMania matches had to that point. A tombstone and a huge win. But nothing lasts forever, and Undertaker was about to learn this very painful lesson courtesy of Brock Lesnar. Oh yeah, you already know what this is about. Brock returned to WWE from the world of mixed martial arts in 2012, ready to conquer the world. A loss to John Cena would quickly derail the hype, but a rebound victory over Triple H at SummerSlam seemed to have the Beast back on track. Still, Brock wasn't where he wanted to be as of the fall of 2013 approached, so he took a sabbatical from WWE. He'd return near the end of the year, demanding a WWE Championship match. Despite attempting to force the match, Brock was not given what he wanted. Instead, he'd receive an open contract for an opponent at WrestleMania. And this open contract would be answered by none other than The Undertaker, who would sign in Brock's blood after putting him through a table. It seemed impossible. Undertaker's streak was beyond legend. With names like Diesel, Randy Orton, Triple H, and Shawn Michaels all proudly displayed on the list. Even someone as monstrous as Brock Lesnar was seen as an underdog heading into the encounter. But Lesnar and his manager, Paul Heyman, were confident that they had what they needed to send a shockwave throughout all of WWE. They knew that with a win at WrestleMania, the world would be Brock's. He wouldn't have to demand anything ever again. It'd just be given to him. And New Orleans, Louisiana was prepared to see two of WWE's baddest brawlers collide in the center of the ring. Would an F5 send Undertaker's streak spinning? Would Undertaker find a way to send yet another opponent to rest with the other lost souls? You're going to have to step into the most intimidating scenario in WWE history. Competing against The Undertaker at WrestleMania. You managed to protect the streak earlier. Can you now bring it to an end and leave everyone in attendance speechless?
And a huge overhead belly-to-belly let everyone know that Brock wasn't intimidated. Undertaker, on the other hand, needed to employ his mental warfare, like landing on his feet when Brock tried to clothesline him to the floor to keep an edge on Brock. Neither man had a huge power advantage over the other, so it would be Undertaker's mind games against Brock's freakish athleticism. Brawling on the apron didn't get either man very far, though Undertaker was able to hit a shot on Brock over the top rope to get back into the match. The two had smashed each other with huge punches and knees, yet neither seemed to feel the effects. The WWE... Brock had Undertaker against the ropes here and was ready to start putting it on him. Talking trash and taunting Undertaker after each clubbing blow, Brock was firmly in control. You can see the distant look in Undertaker's eyes as he tries to stay on his feet. No one had treated Undertaker like this before, and it was shocking to see Undertaker seemingly helpless against the onslaught of the Beast. Undertaker would dig deep, finding a DDT to put Brock down on the mat. Could Lesnar capitalize here? Undertaker was back to his feet first, but barely, still staggering in the corner. Brock looked to kill the comeback immediately, but ran into Undertaker's boot. The Phenom would need to stay alert and push the action if he was going to conquer the Beast. Brock refused to give Undertaker any room to breathe, smothering him whenever possible, and the effects were clear on Undertaker's face. But Undertaker would catch Brock with another big boot, and that gave him the opening to take Brock to school. Old school. Brock continued to shine in WrestleMania's most dangerous scenario. How did Brock manage to catch Undertaker like that? Proving time after time, he would not wither. But Undertaker would show his supernatural resiliency, able to kick out of the F5 when it certainly seemed to many that he was finished. Undertaker was struggling in there with Brock, but wasn't out yet. Surely he'd be able to get back into this match and continue his WrestleMania domination? Brock's face is the picture of frustration here, but it seems misplaced when he's got firm control of this match. The big question right now is, what can Undertaker do to get back into the match? How can he keep the streak alive?
Thank you.
That had seen Lesnar thwart Undertaker at every turn continued that trend. Will the tombstone be the answer, as it had been so many times before? The way Brock manhandled Undertaker to get him set for the F5 after he reversed the tombstone, looking back, it's so obvious that Undertaker's out. But at the moment, no one believed it was over, even after the F5. It was Undertaker. He'd kick out. He had to kick out. But he didn't. The looks on the faces. Just look at the shock on every fan in attendance. No one expected that to be it. And that speaks volumes about what Undertaker had built. The man had already survived multiple F5s, and the fans still thought he'd be able to survive the last one. Nobody will ever duplicate the 21-0 record that Undertaker set to open his WrestleMania career. Simply competing at 21 WrestleManias is a daunting enough task, but to win every single time out, it may not have lasted forever, but that is still a number that will live forever. And I have to say, I've never in my entire career heard a crowd react the way that crowd reacted to the end of the streak. Hell, I still can't believe it happened. It is still the most shocking ending to any match at WrestleMania. And I'm feeling the goosebumps again right now. Brock Lesnar pins The Undertaker in the middle of the WrestleMania 30 ring, silencing the entire arena. There will never be another Undertaker. But on this occasion, the night belonged to Brock Lesnar as he conquered the juggernaut-like WrestleMania streak of The Undertaker.